The word Viking means a pirate raid in the Old Norse language. The Age of Vikings lasted for just under 300 years, between 900 AD and 1066. They were seafaring people originally from Scandinavia, who from the late 8th to the late 11th centuries raided, pirated, traded, and settled throughout parts of Europe. The Vikings are credited with founding a number of European cities, in fact. They also voyaged as far as the Mediterranean, North Africa, Middle East, Greenland, Canada, and America. In their countries of origin and some of the countries they raided and settled in, this period is popularly known as the Viking Age. I found it extremely difficult to gather information about the Vikings, and this is because they never wrote down their own history. Most of what is known about Vikings and customs comes from what their enemies documented about them. The Vikings spoke Old Norse and made inscriptions in runes, and for most of the period they followed the Old Norse religion and practiced paganism. The head of their gods were Odin and Thor. The Vikings, they never called themselves Vikings, and they did not think of themselves as a united group. There were four major classes of Nordic societies. You had kings, jarls, carls, and thralls. Kings were the rulers, jarls were the noblemen, carls were the farmers, tradesmen, and builders, while the thralls, they were the slave class. Vikings had their own system of law and order, got together to make laws and settle disputes and disagreements. The Norse society was governed by strict laws, which were discussed and decided upon at a meeting called Finn, which was a governing assembly made up of the free people of the community, which was presided over by a law speaker. Finns took place at regular intervals, usually at prominent places that were accessible by travel. They provided legislative functions as well as being social events and opportunities for trade. In modern usage, the meaning of this word in English and other languages has shifted to mean not just assemblage of some sort, but simply an object of any sort. The Vikings are notorious for their impressive shipbuilding skills for their time. Warrior shields were put on the outside of the longships when travelling. It was practical, and it also helped when it crashed into waves. Viking ships were also usually fitted with the heads of dragons and other creatures at the front, believing it would protect them from things like storms, raids, monsters, and of course to evoke fear. Knowledge about the arms and armour of the Viking Age is purely based on archaeological finds and pictorial representation. The most prized weapons of the Vikings were their longswords, but rarely used in battle. Often enough it would be spears, shields and axes. And they would often name their weapons, which were sometimes passed down through generations and generations. Some Vikings would go into a battle in a trance-like state of rage. And these chaps were called berserkers, which later gives rise to the modern English word berserk, meaning furiously violent or out of control. It's also said that they often wore bear or wolf skins into battle. The majority of Vikings spent their time farming barley, rye, oats, as well as raising cattle, goats, pigs, and sheep on farms just big enough to support their family. Vikings have also been known for their fantastic hygiene. Archaeologists have found tweezers, razors, combs, and even ear cleaners at excavation sites. Compared to other cultures, Viking women had more rights than most women. Viking women had the right to own land, divorce their husbands, inherit property. and were considered equals during the 9th to the 13th century, but only 80% of Viking children survived past 5 years old. If a child was sick or weakly, the parents would either abandon the child or, you know, it doesn't sound too pleasant, but they would throw them into the sea. And this was due to the fact that, you know, strong pride Vikings took in strength and power. Canute the Great was one of the most powerful Viking kings. He was King of England from 1016, King of Denmark from 1018, and also King of Norway from 1028 until his death in 1035. The three kingdoms united under Canute's rule are referred together as the North Sea Empire by historians. Did you know the Bluetooth technology which we all have today is named after Harald Blaatand, a 10th century Viking king whose last name translates to Bluetooth, and was renowned for peacefully bringing people from different lands together? The symbol of the Bluetooth logo, which we all know today, is Blaatand's initials in ancient ruins. Now, how awesome is that? Now, pacifism wasn't exactly an option in the Norse world. Viking custom required all free men to own weapons, and they were allowed to be fully armed at all times. The quality of one's gear would reflect their social standing. Vikings invented the rap battle during the 5th, known as flighting. And this is a poetic exchange of insults, often targeting cowardice or perversion. Did you know Vikings were also fond of board games as well? A favourite was Hnefatafl, a strategy game like chess played on a checkered board using figurines representing two rival armies. Wow, sounds a bit like Risk, doesn't it, or something? Yeah, that sounds pretty awesome, that. The Vikings, they also invented what we know today as skis at least 6,000 years ago and kept using them through the Viking Age. The word ski comes from the Old Norse word skio, which means cleft wood or stick of wood. Due to the Norse religion, it was believed that warriors went to incredible realms after their death. Therefore, burying their dead in boats was common to help reach the afterlife. In the boats, the dead were often sent off with their weapons, armour, jewellery, sometimes even sacrificed slaves. Viking raids on Christian settlements, I mean, they were so brutal that many of the monks and priests who lived in them thought that the Vikings were sent from God to punish them for their sins. And this is quite humorous, really. Well, it's not, but during Viking raids, they would refrain from destroying everything. They would leave just enough so people could rebuild their lives, settlements, and this is so they could they would return and raid again. Did you know Vikings celebrated their own type of Christmas by the name of Yule? They exchanged presents during the winter solstice and believed gods flew through the air at night with gifts on their chariot. Now, does this sound familiar to you? Also, Friday was named after Frigg, who was the wife of Odin. Friday is considered a lucky day by some due to its connection to the Viking goddess. Just a quick thank you for joining me at the pond today. I hope you enjoyed and learned something today from these Viking facts. Cover on for some interesting facts and mysteries next time. Thank you. Take care. Bye-bye.